Hey friends, it's Corey from Hey Let's Make Stuff. In today's video, we're going to be talking all about the new WeCreat Vista diode laser. Now, if you remember from a recent video of mine, I actually reviewed the first WeCreat laser, which was the WeCreat Vision. So yes, this one is named the Vista, the other one is named the Vision, and I'm going to do my best to actually get those names right as I'm talking, but if I mess up, don't come for me in the comments. That Vision laser had the auto riser feature, so it went up and down depending on how big of a project you put inside the laser. This laser is obviously much smaller, so there are some differences between the Vision and the Vista, and we're going to talk about those in today's video. I'm also going to give you a full overview of the Vista, tell you who I think it's good for, how much it costs, what it can do, all that stuff I always include in my videos. And of course, if you have any questions about these two lasers or any other type of laser, you can go ahead and leave those down in the comments. So the WeCreat Vista is a 10-watt diode laser. Now, I've reviewed quite a few different diode lasers on my blog. 10 watts is sort of down at the bottom of the power spectrum. However, it is still a very capable laser. You can use this laser to make all sorts of projects like jewelry, signs, other home decor, tumblers. There is a wide range of projects that you can cut, engrave, and score using the Vista. And like I said, this is a diode laser, which means that it is a blue light laser. I have talked about this in so many of my videos, but because that blue light is on the visible light spectrum, it means that it is going to struggle cutting a small number of materials that you might want to cut. Those include clear and blue acrylics and anything sort of in the transparent category. And that's because the laser itself just basically shoots right through the material and it doesn't cut it or engrave it. I do have a very extensive video going into how to cut acrylic using a diode laser. Now, you still can't cut all acrylic, but in that video, I show you that you can cut a lot of colors. So I will go ahead and link that down in the description if you want to check that out. But if you want to cut clear and other transparent acrylic or a lot of shades of blue, you're probably not going to want a diode laser in general, not just the Vista, just any diode laser. You're going to want to upgrade to a CO2 laser, which means that you're going to actually have a much higher price point. A diode laser is much more economical, easier to produce, however, it does have those limitations. Now, at the time I am posting this video, they are doing a pre-sale, which means that you can get this entire laser for just $6.99, which is a really, really great price for a diode laser. Once the early bird is over, that price will go up a little bit. It's actually still really reasonable. I think it's going to be priced at $8.99, but don't quote me on that. There is also an additional rotary kit, which we will talk about here in this video, that you can add on for another $100. But overall, I think this is priced really well. So if you are sort of a hobbyist crafter, an at-home crafter who wants to get into laser crafting, this is definitely a good option for you. I swear, every time I make a laser video, I talk about how easy this setup is. And this one, it was even easier than the other easy ones I've done. I think it took me maybe 10 minutes to set up the whole thing. I feel like all of these laser companies are doing a really good job streamlining that setup process. It was very simple. Even if you're not tech savvy, I think you can have it done in less than 15 minutes. Overall, I can move this laser around my craft room. It's a little difficult just because it's a little bit wide, but it only weighs about 30 pounds, so I'm able to do it. However, if you struggle with anything heavier than 30 pounds, you'll probably want a family member to help you out. All right, I have the specs here written down because they are not like perfectly even numbers, so I'm going to go ahead and just give you the numbers straight off the website. So the machine dimensions are it's 25.31 inches long by 18.5 inches deep. It's less than 7 inches tall, which is really great, giving it that low profile. However, you do need the full 19 inches to open it. So if you have a shelf or something, there's a feature in this laser that means that you will need to open the lid to its maximum capacity. I'll share that here in a little bit. So don't think that you can kind of, you know, put this on a shelf and lift the lid a little bit, put what you want in and close it. No, you need that full 19 inches to be able to open the lid all the way. You will probably want another 6 to 8 inches in the back of the machine to account for the vent pipe and cords and things that are back here. The inside of the machine is fairly simple. It does have a crumb tray that you can pull out from the outside of the machine, which has anything that has fallen through as you've been cutting. And then on the inside, there are two removable slate panels. And these are basically racks that lift up any type of cutting project so that you get airflow underneath, which means that you get less charring and less fire risk. I have to say, I loved the slate panels in the WeCreat Vision. I love them in the Vista. I have a lot of diode lasers, and I really feel like this is the best solution. They are easy to put in. They're easy to remove. It's only two pieces. I feel like overall, I'm really happy with how they have sort of engineered these slate panels. very good. Then you also have the laser arm with the laser head. So like I said before, I have the 10 watt here installed in my machine. They also have a 2 watt infrared laser. So this is a different type of laser. It's infrared versus that blue light. And it is designed not to cut, but to actually engrave things like metal. So if you are a jewelry maker and you want to do engraving, this is actually the laser head that you're going to want to use. You'll want to add this on. However, if you want to cut wood and leather and some acrylic and those sorts of things, then you're going to want that 10 watt diode laser. Swapping these out is pretty darn easy. It's just a few screws. I was really pleased with how easy the swapping was. Now, something that makes these two laser modules unique and makes the Vista a unique diode laser is the fact that WeCreat has made them flippable or rotatable. I'm not really sure what the best wording here is. I'm going to use the 2-watt here to sort of explain what I'm talking about. So basically, any other laser I have seen, at least in the hobbyist space, the laser processes from the top down. So it basically shoots that laser down and it processes whatever you have underneath it. But using the specialized bracket that is on both this laser head as well as that 10 watt, you can rotate this. So you can rotate it 90 degrees, which means that the laser is now actually processing toward the back of the machine. Now, why would you want to do this? Well, that is one of the ingenious things about this laser. Instead of needing to have a riser base to do things like tumblers or other large projects, you can process those from the side. So instead of needing a whole bunch of, say, let's say my arm is the tumbler, instead of needing a whole bunch of extra space above the tumbler to be able to engrave it, we've now flipped it on its side and it can engrave it from the top without needing any extra space above it. This makes this laser really unique, and it also means that you don't need a riser base. So with pretty much every other laser here in my craft room, if it is possible to have a riser base, I have it sitting on a riser base, and that's because I'm going to want to be able to do taller projects like tumblers with it. But those riser bases are not cheap, and it's an extra purchase when you're already spending a lot of money on a machine. So I think that this was really ingenious of WeCreat to create this sort of flippable laser to get around needing a riser base. And then if you do want to lift this up to process something that is larger that's not going to work with that flippable laser, they do have these little riser legs. So these just screw onto the feet of the laser, and I think you can order more of these, and they are stackable. So let's say you wanted to have it twice as high, you could stack these. And I believe these come with the laser. I'm not 100% positive. Mine were shipped separately, but I also got a pre-production model. But I do believe that these are going to be included. So if you do want to lift it up, the riser base, these little legs, come with it, and you don't have to buy a whole extra riser base. Flipping the module is super easy. It just has these little hand screws on the sides. You kind of pull them out, flip it, and push them back in and screw them in. It's very, very easy to flip that laser. Another thing that WeCreat includes that is extra on other lasers is this little air assist. Now, an air assist basically blows air onto your project as it's processing, whether it's cutting or engraving or scoring, it's going to blow some air onto that project. This helps reduce charring and it helps reduce the fire risk. So no matter what laser you get, I highly recommend getting an air assist, but it's also not one of those things that's super cheap when you buy it as an add-on to other lasers. So the fact that WeCreat includes one in the box, they did this with the Vision. I really, really appreciate that. And then there's one more special feature to this laser that I've not seen in any of the diode lasers that I have that I really like. So I am not a big fan of the fisheye lens that ends up being in most lasers. So basically you need that fisheye lens to take a photo of the bed of your machine so you can figure out where you put your material. However, a fisheye lens automatically distorts things, especially toward the edges. And that always bothers me because I feel like I can't get an accurate cut sometimes. So if you remember, I talked about in the beginning of this video how you do need that 19 inches of space when you open this machine. So I'm going to go ahead and open it now. And that is because it has a camera that's actually in the lid. So it's very hard for me to get a good video of, but there is a camera up here, which means that this camera is what takes a picture of the bed of your laser while this is open. And because it's so much higher, just in distance from the bed of the laser than other lasers when you have it closed and you're using a fisheye, you get a much more accurate picture of what's in the bed. And as someone who really wants to use every scrap of material that I have, I want to get everything as close as I can, but I don't want to waste anything by accidentally going off the edge. I have to say that I absolutely love this solution. It really takes care of that fisheye lens problem, and honestly, it's not very difficult to use. It's exactly the same way to process things as you would with a fisheye lens, however, you're just getting a much more accurate photo. And then I'm going to cover venting. I cover this in all my videos. If you are using a laser, you do need to vent it. And that's because when the laser is processing, whether it is engraving or cutting or scoring, it is removing material from whatever you're processing. And that removed material turns into smoke and dust and debris and all sorts of yucky stuff that you don't want to be just releasing into your craft space. So you do need to vent it. And there are a couple options. So for this machine, I'm just venting it out of a window. I have the vent pipe attached to the back, and that's just running out a window over here, which I have basically sealed around the pipe so that all of that goes outside. They also have an air purifier, smoke filter. There's a bunch of different names for it. And if you don't have a window, you will want to get that because you do need a place to be able to vent all of that smoke and everything into so that it doesn't get into your craft space. Another thing I look for in any laser I bring into my craft space is safety. This one has just your basic safety features, but all of them make me very comfortable using the WeCreat Vista in my home. First of all, it has a tinted lid, which means that I can watch my projects processing without hurting my eyes. It also has a full metal enclosure, makes it a little bit heavier, but I do think that that is more fire retardant than something like plastic. You may also see lasers out there that don't have any type of enclosure, which once again, all of that smoke and dust and debris is just being put into your craft space. So I highly recommend getting something that is enclosed. Another safety feature that I like is if you go to open the lid while it's processing, the laser will stop. And then they also have their rotary tool. So this is an add-on feature. I think it's about $100 more, and it utilizes a chuck system. So it has this adjustable chuck here. Use a little key to make these little claws go in and out, and they can grip your tumbler or cup or whatever you want to put in there. And then this attaches to this sort of side rail of the laser using two screws. It's very easy to install. Now, I am a big fan of basically any rotary tool because I feel like it can really increase the number of projects you make with your laser. Plus, you can take advantage of the cool flipping, rotating feature of this laser. However, I was playing around in WeCreat Make It, which is their software, and I realized that there is quite a large non-workable area that is close to this chuck. So it is maybe a 3 or 4 inch space that you cannot engrave. It cannot engrave in. And at first I was like, is this what it was on the vision? And actually I think it was, I just happened to do a project that didn't need to be that close to the chuck. But if you want to do something like a full wrap or a small mug, I was trying to do a small mug, I wasn't able to do it. And so I emailed the folks at WeCreat and said, guys, what's going on here? I really need some help because I can't seem to engrave this entire thing. And their solution was to buy chuck extenders. Now, there are a bunch of shops on Etsy that sell these sort of extenders. I think they're 3D printed. And I will go ahead and link to one down in the description below. And it's basically these pieces, but they're about this long so that you can have your cup or your tumbler or whatever farther away from the edge of this non-processing area. The solution probably works fine. I have actually not gotten my extenders by the time I needed to make this video. I don't see why they wouldn't work. The shop that I bought from has a lot of really good reviews. However, this is something that I think WeCreat should be including in the box. If they have a large non-working area, I think that they as a company should combat that and actually give you those extenders. So I think the rotary tool is good because it can expand, obviously, the number of projects you can make. However, be aware of that non-working area because it can be really frustrating. Does it make me not want to use it? No, it was an extra $20 expense from Etsy, and I'll be able to use it just fine once they come. However, I just want you to keep that in mind when you're thinking about purchasing, that you may need to buy that little extra. And at some point, I hope WeCreat comes out with their own extenders. And then I will be honest and say I've not been able to put this through sort of the rigorous testing that I've been able to put some of my other diode lasers through just because of the amount of time that I've had it and getting this video up. For this machine, you'll be using the WeCreat Make It software. You can also use Lightburn, which some people use for lasering. I've never used Lightburn, so I can't really speak to it. The Make It software is fairly basic, but it gets the job done, and I can tell that they are trying to improve it over time. Even since I got my WeCreat Vision, they have made changes and improvements. I think it's just one of those things that as they grow as a company is going to get better and better. But I really didn't have any issue connecting my machine or cutting any of my projects that I test cut. I did test cut a few projects. So this is a pair of earrings. This is one of their free projects. This is the basswood that came with the machine. I was actually really impressed with the piece of basswood that I got. Very flat, very even surface, and these cut absolutely beautifully. I cut the same earrings out of black acrylic, and again, like butter. I have had some issues with one of my 10-watt lasers in the past, not wanting to cut all the way through or taking too many passes. I believe this was one single pass. It cut through beautifully and fast. I was actually really impressed with the cut quality as well as the speed with this machine, considering it's only 10 watts. I didn't have to sort of punch any of these pieces out, and it is just a really clean cut, so I'm definitely impressed with the cutting speed and precision of this machine. So overall, I think this is a really good machine. I have to say I do like it more than the Vision. Even though the Vision has more power, it's a 20 to 40 watt laser, I actually like this one better. I like that the laser module is flippable so that I don't need to have that riser base. With the Vision, it was a little tall. I'm 5'6". I feel like anybody shorter than me might actually struggle to be able to reach into the machine and put things in the bed of the laser. You might need a little step stool or to put it on a lower table. This one obviously has a much smaller footprint when it comes to the height, much easier to work with. Like I said, it's got all of those great safety features, and I'm really impressed with the cut quality and speed. The only thing that I'm not sure about with this laser is with the rotary tool and having that non-working area. Again, you can actually just fix that by going onto Etsy and buying some extenders. However, I wish that was not necessary. WeCreat is really good about having these other things in the box, like the slate panels and the air assist and not having a riser. So I do feel like if they could just get those extenders into the box, it would make this an even better laser. If you want a little overview of how to use the software, you can actually go to my Vision video and watch that. I make a simple project and you can do the exact same project using this machine. So if you're watching this video when it first comes out and you're thinking, yeah, maybe want to bite the bullet, the pricing on this is absolutely excellent and I would grab it. Even after the early bird presale ends, it's still a really great price. And if I was choosing between this and the Vision, I think this would be my choice. I hope you found my review of the WeCreat Vista helpful. If you have any questions about using this laser or any of its features, please let me know down in the comments. If you found this video helpful in your buying decision, I would really appreciate a like. Follow my channel for more crafty content. I'll see you next time.